don't love you today. Testing 1, 2, 3.
So, what are you gonna be reviewing today, Maggie? You gonna review this drone?
Yes.
You are? Okay. Hi, it's Brandon Irdi with Tech Review by Irdi, and today we've got the Xtreme Raptor. This is a drone with camera, 2.4 gigahertz transmitter. I got this for a great deal because you're going to start seeing this show up at a lot of retail outlets that bargain buy or they have buyouts. This one came from Ollies last November at Thanksgiving. This showed up on Black Friday for $19.99. I went yesterday to a grand opening of Ollies. It's now March 10th today, 2017. And there was about 8 of these on the shelf before I came back up to the cash register. This was the last one. So I got it for $19.99. We're going to give it a shot and give it a fly and go through a little review. So stay tuned. So let's take a look in the box real quick here. We've got the transmitter, one of the bigger hobby style transmitters. We have the drone, the quadcopter, the Raptor itself. It's got a battery on board. 380 milliamps, 25C discharge, 3.7. All right, we've got the prop guards over here. And we've got the landing gear. So we got the landing gear, the prop guards, got the camera. I think this is a 2 megapixel camera. We'll double check that once we get the files going. And we've got the bag of prop guards. We've got the prop guards, a screwdriver, the thumbsticks for the controller, so when you open this up, there's no thumbsticks on there. Don't take it back. Just look in the bag here, and that's where they're at. And the typical little USB charger. Probably flashes red when it's ready to charge, and probably goes out when it's charging, but we'll find out that as well. Now, this is an RTF ready-to-fly model, so there should be a charge on these Lipo batteries, which is the natural state of lithium anyways. We'll find out shortly once we get this all set up and ready to fly. Let's see what else we have in here though. For paperwork, we've got Xtreme is social, join the party at their website, and every month we will select a winner. Okay, that's a little promo package. And for a quadcopter, we've got a really small manual. It's tiny. Now you can download the manual off Xtreme.com. Xtreme actually has a lot of different products they sell. They have several different drones as well. This one being the Raptor. There is a mini Raptor as well. It's a little smaller than this. And then there is an Xtreme Flyer, which has got the X design that you usually see on Cimas or Cimas, like the X4s, 5Cs, stuff like that. But anyways, let's just go ahead and take a real quick look at this as well. So we're gonna get the transmitter. The transmitter's got regular functions on here, just like every transmitter you pretty much have for a little drone. Trim for your left and right. And you've got your pitch forward and backwards, left and right. You've also got these four buttons up here. Now this one's not functional, the second one. And the first one is called easy mode, and I'm not exactly sure what that means, because there is a speed button up here and should have a variable speed, at least 2 or 3. We'll find out shortly as well. It's got the flip button at the top up here. And these two buttons in the green background here, the outside is the smaller file creator, which is photo. And the interior one is the larger file creator, which is video. So that should be about it. Now a lot of these controllers also have this little nub here. We're gonna take this apart later on and see if we can extend that interior antenna a little bit, but otherwise than that,
should be about good to go. Let's go ahead and give this thing a little charge in the flight and see where we are. Let's give this thing a little bit of time to get put together here, and then we'll take it for a flight. And to bind the transmitter, same thing as usual, throttle up, throttle back, there we go. We'll make sure this is calibrated, so joysticks to the outer bottom. There we go. Alright, and I have an SD card in there now, so we can also get some video. I'll turn that on. There we go. And it's starting to flash, showing that video is recording. We're in speed mode number one. We'll hit the button for speed two. Let me bring this down real quick so you can hear the beeps. And speed three. So it's followed by the number of beeps that you're in. So we'll go with it. Speed one, speed two, speed three. Okay. We'll take off in speed three, make it more agile. Try flipping here real quick. Woo. It's a big one, so it's a little hard to try sideways. Pretty nice little flyer. As cheap as the plastic is. And the plastic is cheap. The blades are very flexible. I'm going to shut off the video real quick on this. New video again. You can beat it without a drone. Smaller maybe. But for the size, that's pretty cool.
try to put my hand on. Fly back inside. Woo! Damn, that wind catches it so quickly. It's really light though. Let's go inside.
Okay, folks, so we took the Xtreme Raptor out. We took it for some test flight indoor as well as one outdoor. The lights do not shine through the body very well at all. They literally are at the bottom of these in green and blue. They do spotlight the ground though, so you can see them pretty far above the ground. Now this Raptor Xtreme is actually also a Mould King 33041. There's a Mould King 33041A as well, ones with and without the camera. This one came with the camera. It's okay. It's a typical camera that you see on the cheaper drones. Not very good surveillance, but just good for aerial photographs and video. But otherwise than that, very plasticky, very cheap, but most drones in this sub $50 category is in that area. You can replace all the pieces on this Xtreme Raptor with Mould Kings as well. So you can look at those online, and they're about the same price. So the Mould King comes in a white as well. Okay, let's wrap this up real quick. Again, it's a good buy if you can find it. It's not the best quality of quadcopters ever, but it definitely can handle some abuse. Pick one up if you can. The Xtreme Raptor with camera, otherwise known as the Mould King 33041.
Please subscribe.